I'm talking about solarization, not about EIF now, okay? And this is the same field as you saw in the previous slide, okay? The preparation, by the way, sprinklers, they gave a very good irrigation before we applied solarization film. And by the way, solarization film always a transparent film, okay? Why? Because we need the light to get through, okay? To create a greenhouse effect between the polyethylene and the soil. So you could see very nice preparation, good irrigation a day before, and then you could see here the client tractor with our mulch layer machine. We are borrowing this mulch layer machine. I'm coming to the field, adjusting it, and they buy it from us because of the mulch layer machine. By the way, Polytive still don't have a mulch layer machine. So this is how it looks, very nice, very smooth, etc. By the way, again, solarization for conventional potatoes. This is a, you know, a picture we took it from above, and all these fields that you see, it's a continuous mulch application for solarization combined with methane sodium for conventional potatoes here in Israel, south of Tel Aviv. Okay, so as I said before, clear film, good preparation, okay, mainly from organic, but also for conventional. We could combine the solarization with agrochemical like the lawn, like methane sodium together, okay? As you could see, we are dealing here with the carrot, potatoes, tomatoes for processing. And also we had a huge success 2 years ago with peanuts in the south part of Israel. And I want to, so again, what I would like to do now is I want to share with you videos that gonna transfer what we are doing. Okay, so we're gonna start with the solarization, okay? Wide application, and you're gonna see it's very interesting, okay? In the end of the day, we cover all the field, and this is a huge advantage because we are dealing also, okay, with the path in between the beds, which in the narrow way, you're gonna see it later on, we are not dealing. So it's sterilizing also in between the beds here. So with your permission, I'm gonna share with you the presentation. I'm gonna explain a bit. So what you could see here, okay, this is in Kibbutz Sad. You could see the beds here. We are using plastic bags full with sand to throw it on the film and keep it. So what's happening? You see one side here, we are burying the polyethylene, while on the other side, there is a gas heater with a wheel, and we are welding this film to the previous one. In other words, in the next stage, a film gonna be welded here on this side. And in the end of the day, what we are getting? We are getting a continuous cover on all the field. By the way, this is for organic carrot in Kibbutz Sa'ad, close to the Gaza Strip. Very impressive. It was 20 hectares that we did over here, here in Israel.
This is how many microns? 30 microns?
It's 40 micron. We had some issues in the previous years because during this period, it's very hot and there are a lot of winds. So we decided to increase it from 40 to 45 micron, Rajiv. And you could see here how we weld it, okay? How it looks. You see a heater with gas and then a wheel which is pressing and welding between the two films performing a continuous coverage. Okay? This is also in potatoes close to Tel Aviv. We apply first metam sodium in a different with a different tractor, and then we apply the film. So you could see here on this edge, it's the welding part between the two films. You see, this is the roll. By the way, the width is 0.8 meters.
And this is Asgard, right, Yoram?
So you see potatoes, this is how it looks. I want to show you how strong is this film. You could see I tried to lift it on the welding part over here, you see?
Same. Very weak.
Very weak, correct. Now, again, you know, polyethylene, it's a waste. It should be friendly to environment. So one we are doing, once we finish the solarization, we cut the film in the middle, and we get a special drum in order to collect the polyethylene, in order to send it to
recycling.
Recycling, correct. So you could see.
Do you collect mulching also like this?
The tractor is collecting the polyethylene.
Yoram?
Yes.
Do you collect mulching also like this?
So this is what we do now.
Do you collect mulching also the same way?
Yes, of solarization, we do. There is some issue with, you know, here it's only 45 days, a month and a half. One of the main issues is that the recyclers doesn't want to get a dirty product because they need to invest a lot of money in order to clean it from the sand and the dirt. But with this material, they are getting it. So you could see that Ginegar is a company which is trying to be friendly to environment and to push to recycling. And the last step is the recycler, which is coming to the field and loading to a truck. Polyethylene in order to... Any questions about the wide solarization application of soft agrochemicals like telon and metam sodium, combination of both of them? Very interesting. The main issue is that you need the machine for that and the big, huge fields. By the way, we are mainly applying it at night because there is less wind and heat easier. And the tractor is able to push around with one layer machine like that, 5 hectares per night.
Per night?
Per night, yeah. They start generally, you know, it's depending on the condition, how the field was prepared, winds, etc. A lot of parameters. But it's very interesting to see, you know, you see it's impressive, it's effective. It's catching very much. Also for conventional and organic.
The mulch that they are using is all 40 microns only, or they use also 30 microns?
Again, on the narrow beds, which is the next slides that I'm going to share with you, we could decrease the thickness. Why? Because it's more narrow, and there is less, you know, risk that the film going to blow up. Here it's very, very risky. You could see here that they didn't install the bags as they did in the south. But again, it's issue of microclimate, wind direction, you know, slopes, etc.
So which, this is all for potatoes, that you carrot, potatoes, tomatoes?
Yeah, I wrote it here. What we are mainly applying it now for organic carrot, potatoes, mainly conventional, organic tomato for processing, and recently conventional peanuts as well.
Do you use the same mulch for the conventional peanuts also?
Yes, in the peanuts we are using this one, correct? We're gonna run this year 15 hectares in the south, in Kibbutz Nirim. Gonna try also the thinner one with the you know, narrow beds that you're gonna see in a minute. So again, what I would like to summarize it for you, this approach is a bit more complicated. It needs the, you know, the machinery, okay? I think application with a narrow bed, we could start with that in India. Of course, we need, you know, a month and a half that the temperatures are high enough in order to get the right heat under the polyethylene. And you're going to see in a minute. So once we finish, we cut it in the middle in order to split it. It's easier to collect. So here you could see this is a organic carrot in close to the Gaza Strip, okay? And you could see what we did here. We did part of it continuous and part of it narrow bed. And what I could tell you is that the results were also satisfying over here on the narrow, okay? But again, it's depending a lot which crop we are talking about and how is the field, which are the pathogens which are existing. No doubt that this is the ideal, but this could work as well.
So what is the width that you use for the wide width thing, and what is the width that you use for the narrow bed?
Okay, first of all, it's depending on the bed's width, okay? But generally, the wide one, we are using 4.8 meters. But part of it is going to the soil and part of it is for overlap and welding. Okay, here on the narrow beds for carrots, meters. Okay, so we are using between 2.2 meters to 220, depending on the height of the beds. Because if the beds are extremely high, the film should be wider.